Hey everybody, it's Poltergeist 5000, back with a new LP of a game that I did not expect to be playing when I woke up this morning. Yeah, I woke up this morning and I had no clue what I was going to be recording, because I had nothing planned, really. The only thing I could remember was this. I was thinking of watching the end of Super Metroid again to see if I mentioned anything in the credits, because I didn't mention anything in the credits of Diddy's Conquest, and that was the last thing I uploaded, so. This is AM2R. Another Metroid 2 remake. The Metroid 2 fan game. The Metroid fan game that came out, like, maybe a month ago? 2 months ago? I don't know. And got DMCA'd by Nintendo within 2 days. So that was pretty much... That pretty much stay lank. It wasn't a DM... Was it? I don't think it was a DMCA claim. It was just a cease and desist or something. But, yeah. Let me turn the sound effects up here. First time I tried to record this. This is, like, take 4 of this. The first time I tried to record this, I had the music turned way down, like off, because I'd been playing this while watching Critical Role, but no, whatever. Those are my last two playthroughs, but we're gonna start a new game, and I'm gonna play on hard because this game's I'm pretty good at this game, not gonna lie. Metroids. Numerous incidents in the past have brought to light the highly destructive power of these life forms, spreading fear across all known planetary systems. Hoping to secure peace in the galaxy, the Galactic Federation orders the extermination of the Metroid species. I was the best candidate for the job. Who's the guy in the glasses? Jeez. Once again, I find myself standing alone against the Metroid menace. If I had known Samus was narrating, I would have spoken in her voice a little bit earlier. What horrors await me within the depths of their homeworld? Who knows? I've never seen this screen before. I usually skip the intro. Man, sideways shot of the ship looks like a lemon or something. Anyway. Here we go. Metroid 2, or AM2R, more like it. Yeah. Why is the music not starting? Does that actually wait for me to go into the cave? Huh. I don't remember that. Why is there no music? Come on, I turned the music on. There we go. Jeez. What the heck? That was weird. That thing just swooped down at me. Dude, what are you doing? Oh, this is not a good... Oh my gosh, this is not a good indicator of how the rest of this series is gonna go. You can't be blowing it this early. I didn't know those things could swoop down at you. Oh man, how many more things am I gonna discover about this game that I didn't know? Like the one time I need to be good at the game. This is gonna be bad, isn't it? This shouldn't take too long, though. I can beat this game in less than, like, 2.5 hours. I can't beat it in less than 2 hours. Not yet. You need to do some fancy shine spark fuck to do that. Anyway. Let's go this way. You can't actually go this way, but... Yeah, if you try to go this way, there's something... What is even in the way here? There's just lava that you can't get past. Let's save. So I'm gonna take my time. This is gonna be a 100% playthrough. Because it's not that hard to find everything in this game. Yeah. So this is going to be a 100% playthrough. I'm probably not going to be able to beat it in under 2 hours. I'm just going to be doing... You know, taking a leisurely pace. If I ever get, like, the good ending later... Like, if I ever have a particularly good fast run of the game... I'll, like, cut in at the final boss to record that and show you guys the ending or something. I don't fucking know. Come on, hop up. Dude, what the heck? You took 3 hits the first time I killed one of you guys. Just shoot a missile at you. Yeah, whatever. Wrecked. Oh, man. This game just... Oh, man. I freaking love this game. Just playing this right now is just like... Oh, feels good, man. The controls are so smooth and... The art is so nice, even though a lot of the assets are ripped from Zero Mission, it still looks fantastic, and I'm pretty sure the Samus sprites are handmade, so... Uh-oh. Metroid's hatching. What? Oh my gosh, what the hell is this thing? Oh man, this is... Okay, if there's gonna be one part where I fuck up, it's gonna be against these Alpha Metroids. Because these things are kind of a pain in the ass. Okay. Even on the hard... Even on... Those things don't drop energy on hard? Oh no. Oh no, that's... No, that's not good. I'm hoping that was just a glitch, or like a quirk of the first Metroid, and not how all the Metroids are gonna act, because I don't think I've actually played this game on hard before. I thought I had, but maybe I haven't. Man, if they don't drop energy, then I'm gonna be in a real pickle. Because that's gonna make this so much fucking harder. I don't know, I shouldn't die too often. If I do die, it's going to be against an Alpha Metroid, though. Or it's gonna be against the Metroids. It's not gonna be against any of the other bosses, it's gonna be against Metroids, because the Metroids are probably the hardest part of this game. The Alpha Metroids, they were really easy to fight in the original game, because you could just shoot them anywhere, but now you actually gotta shoot them on the bottom, and they do whatever they can to stop you from doing that. And it's a real pain in the ass. I'm gonna have to take every single opportunity I can to save. Okay, yeah, sub 2 hours is definitely a pipe dream if I'm gonna have to be going back to save every single time I fight a Metroid. The Metroid. I'm gonna have to take some precautions, get some items earlier that I would normally hold off on getting until I'd gotten a little bit further in an area. Okay, just... Jeez, man. One thing I really love about the missiles in this game is that they actually have, like, an explosion when you fire them. Which can hit enemies like that are like around corners from where you shoot it, or like behind walls even, and it also hits them multiple times. So even if the initial impact doesn't kill them, usually the ensuing explosions will. Oh come on, sheesh! Ah! Okay, those guys go down. Those guys go fast when they're going down slopes. All right, you die. I kill you. You die. I'm not fantastic at this game. I'm just gonna warn you now. I'm pretty good at it, but that's just because I'm pretty good at Metroid. Period. I don't really have any specific skills about this game. Oh, well, I wonder if like those things swooping down, because I had never seen that before. And you know what else I've never done before is played on hard. I wonder if there are actually different enemy AIs on harder difficulties. Because that would be news to me. You guys have more health, too. That's probably why those guys took 4 hits to kill, is because I'm on hard. Oh man, this is gonna be rough, isn't it? Maybe I shouldn't have played on hard. Oh boy. Anyway, here we are in pretty much World 1. I love these between areas where there's, like, no music. I know some people, like, really don't like when there's no music in a game, but I think in Metroid it usually just helps the atmosphere. Because they don't do it where there should be music, you know? Unless you're talking about Metroid 2. That game's weird. Yeah, these guys are definitely taking more hits. Those guys only take 1 hit on normal. This is gonna be bad. Oh my. This is gonna be really rough. And you know, I could have started doing Five Nights at Freddy's this week. But I want to save that for when we're a little closer to Halloween, because I don't know how much I'm really going to want to play that. I'm telling you, I love the Five Nights at Freddy's franchise, but I can't play the games for more than one night at a time, so... Yeah, I'm a wuss. Let's stop talking about that, though, shall we? Let's start talking about Metroid 2. I love this music. Let's stop talking so we can actually hear it, maybe. Thankfully, these guys still die in one... Okay, I was going to say this guy still died in one missile, and then I shot a missile at him, and then he didn't die. Granted, it hit the wall right next to him, but normally that would still kill him just because of the explosive radius. Here we get, bombs, yeah. Bomb, 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 bomb. That doesn't work for that. It only works with like, 2-syllable or greater ones. Missile, 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 go. It's the only time we're gonna be able to sing that, because all subsequent missile packs will just give you, like, the little, like, sound effect, you know? If anybody knows what I'm talking about, you're amazing. Okay, get out of here! These guys shoot faster, too! Jeez, man. Holy cow. What have I gotten myself into by hitting hard? Oh, boy, Babalooney. Oh, man. That is so dumb. No, don't fall all the way back down. What are you doing? Dude! I'm failing. Okay, wait, no, I'm going the wrong way. I'm going the wrong way again. Get some more toilet paper. Ow. Those things also travel faster? They did not travel that fast before. I tell you what. Secret up here, hit that, and then it'll open up a thing over here. Man, you would not believe how long it took for me to figure out how to do that. Because there's really nothing that indicates that you have to shoot. There's another puzzle like that later, and I didn't even realize that I could shoot those things on the ceiling. We'll see in a second here exactly what I'm talking about. But, oh, jeez, I'm falling. I'm gonna get you. Alright, let's just get out of here. Deal with those guys down there. What is this? This is the charge beam. The pain. Oh man, I'm stretching so hard and it feels so good and it feels so bad and this pain, the agony is coursing through my veins. I need to get that charge beam going. Man, that can't even one-shot those guys. Maybe I should not even bother. Come here. Yeah, one thing about this game that's really cool is just like in the Metroid Prime series, you can actually use the charge beam to suck in power-ups, which I think is just so awesome. I wonder if Nintendo Reason is ever going to finish streaming AM2R. Because he started, and he never finished. One thing I'm kind of worried about with Nintendo Capri Sun streaming is that he's going to start, like, streaming a lot of games that maybe he ought to be LPing. You know? I mean, because the thing is, you know, what is a stream if not just a, you know, an LP that you watch all at once, you know, live? It's not like, you know, you look at how many LPers actually, how many streamers actually read their chat, you know? It's just like an LP where the LPer doesn't get a chance to take breaks when they want to, except in like 5-minute intermissions when they're like really desperate, you know. Oh, come on. Yep, there you go. Like Punch Out Wii. Nintendo Capri Sun keeps saying he's gonna stream that. It's like no, you should LP it, man. Because that would be so much better as an LP. There you go. It took me so long to figure out you could do that, and I didn't figure out that you could do that. I think I read it somewhere. Because how the hell are you supposed to know that you can shoot these things? They just look like background objects. At least that's what they looked like to me when I first played the game. And in that other room, I didn't notice those broken blocks that you can bomb to get up to that other one, to open that other thing, to get that pyramid open, to get the energy tank in there. Is there something over here? Or is this just a way out? Yeah, this is just a way out. I don't give a shit about that. Man, I can't wait to get Spring Ball. Ugh. Spring Ball makes traveling so much faster. Because jumping, I don't know if you noticed, but when I jump and when I land, I lose all my momentum the moment I land. Man, you guys shoot fast. You guys are crazy. This goes out. Yeah, I don't want to go out. Yeah, you may have noticed that when I jump, when I land, after I jump, I lose all my momentum. Well, you don't lose all your momentum if you're in ball form, which makes ball form definitely the fastest way to move around, bar shine sparking. But shine sparking requires so much skill to do, like, I can't even do it. Shit, I'm gonna get hit by... Oh, no, I don't. I thought that if you... Ugh, jeez. Those guys shoot fast! Wowie zowie. Anyway, little hole in the wall there, you can blow through this, I think. Okay, can we just move? This is one thing that actually drives me a little bit crazy about this game, is that it's almost impossible. Ugh. Okay, let's just do that. Wait for those blocks to come back. There you go. He said it's really hard to move just a little bit when you're in ball form because there's a little bit of lag when you push the button. It's like the game is trying to make sure you really wanted to to move. It's like, yeah, I really want it to move. And there's none of that lag when you're walking. But there is when you're in ball form, which is when you need to move, like, tiny, minute amounts. La-da-dee-da. La-da-dee-da. I just said that, man. Ow. Well, excuse you. Oh, man, you know what the other thing was? Because I didn't find those two energy tanks, it took... I did the, like, the entire first area of the game with no extra energy tanks. I am off-center, and it's bugging me. Okay. And let me tell you, that didn't go very well. Let's head down here. No, not like that. Sheesh. Spider, 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 spider ball. I like this fanfare because it's actually in my range better than the Super Metroid one. I could spider ball up here, but frankly, I don't give a shit. Yeah, spider ball, now that we have that, we can do this, which means we can grab onto walls, which is incredibly helpful, but it'll be even more helpful once we have the spring ball. Where are my missiles? Did I shoot a missile between after stopping at that save point? But yeah, so now we got the spider ball, we can come up here, which is leading the way to another Alpha Metroid, which is probably going to kick my ass. Probably should have saved at that save point as opposed to saving at that load point. Shit. Shit. Okay. Ugh. Fuck. Get him. Get him. There you go. Later on, these guys are gonna start dodging, like, every second. Yeah, those guys don't drop energy on hard mode! Oh my gosh, I can't believe it! That is so brutal! Oh man, this is gonna be so much harder than all my previous playthroughs, but that's good, because otherwise I would've just blazed through the game pretty much, except for the Metroid encounters. This is gonna be bad. There might even be some fail montages once we start getting into later forms of the Metroid life cycle. This isn't gonna be good. But then, I'll see a beautiful victory underneath and I'll say 10 out of 10. Except it'll probably take a few takes. Oh no. Lay some bombs. I love that you can lay bombs really fast and they blow up really fast. It's just so cathartic. You just feel so good. Doom. Geez, what the hell was that? Did these guys... Oh, man. Every single enemy in the game has new AI in hard mode, don't they? I didn't even know that. This is gonna be an ordeal. I'm almost up to 20 minutes. I'm gonna finish the first area, because I can do that before the end of the episode. For sure, but... I think now that I have the spider ball, I'm supposed to just go to the breeding grounds of this area, because every area in the game has, like, the area, and then, like, related breeding grounds. Except the third area, I think. Or, no, the fourth area. I always get the third and fourth areas confused, because I always forget that the third area exists. I guess, it's not really getting me confused, is it? Okay, where the hell is the missile expansion that I know is along the ceiling here somewheres? Jeez, it's all the way over here. I should have come out the other side. Jeez. Alright, whatever. I love that they get that they have that music in here. Okay, would you stop? Okay. Sheesh! Yeah, look at that guy. Look at that butt munch, ass munch, ass butt. Okay, that works. No, I want that. Okay, that could have gone about a million times better. Alright, now that we have the spider ball, I think we can head down here. I don't think I missed anything up there. No, I don't think I did. Let's save, because we're going to need to. Oh, 46 is my max missiles. Do they actually give you missiles in groups of 2 in this game? I thought it was in groups of 5 in this game. I don't think you actually need spider ball. I think you just need bombs. But you definitely want to pick up spider ball, because then you can skip that whole fuck fest down there. I mean, you could skip that just by wall jumping, I think, but it would definitely be a lot harder. Am I actually going to need to cut out failures? Come on, ambush me, you stupid Alpha Metroid. Where are you? There you are. Okay, I need to get lower than it. Whew. Okay, that was good. That was good. No power-ups! You gotta be kidding me, man! Oh my gosh. This is gonna be bad. Oh no. Oh lordy, no! I can't do this with no power-ups. If it gets too bad, I'll just start again. Oh, get out of here. Yeah, there you go. They're dodging now. Fuck. Get out of there. Shit. Get over me, you fuck! Huh. Okay. That could have gone about a million billion times better. Is that gonna be? Please don't tell me that's gonna be what the rest of what this whole LP is gonna be like. Me having to run back to a save point after every single Alpha Metroid. Oh no. Oh, and the save point is like 50,000 miles, million, thousand years away, man. This is gonna take forever. I could have held that longer if I'd gotten a deeper breath beforehand. Oh well, should I stop the episode? No, I can't stop the episode. We've already done 2/3 of the breeding grounds. It'd be dumb to stop now. If I was gonna stop, I should have stopped before I started the breeding grounds, not in the middle of it cheerfully. Alright, let's go get our ass kicked by this Metroid. Because you know what's probably gonna happen. Yeah, here we go. Here come the boss, man. Alright, you just approach me there. There you go. Alright, no, don't go underneath. Fuck. I'm sorry if I shut up for a lot of these Alpha Metroid fights, but these really require a lot of focus, actually. It's a good thing the music is nice and tense and oh, give me that wrist massage. So much vibration. The vibration of the earthquake is so beautiful. Seriously, that feels so fucking good. Oh man. Alright, well that didn't take too long. There's a fruit fly in here and it's driving me bonkers! Okay, I'm gonna save, and next time on AM2R, we're gonna find out what that earthquake was, and then I'm probably gonna get my ass kicked by another Alpha Metroid. Hooray! Bye!